and welcome back to Be More Academy, the place to be if you want to unlock your potential and live your best life. Woo-hoo. Today we're gonna talk about something awesome. It's to help you learn how to say no and not feeling bad about it. Because if you want to grow and deliver your message, if you want to, you know, deliver and live your best life, you will have to say how to say yes and how to say no to people and opportunities that are showing up. Because if you are unable to say no to some of the things or most of the, you know, shiny things, you will end up doing things that you don't like and doing it with the people you don't really appreciate. And, you know, doing it in the environment that doesn't really support you or is gonna even be stressful for you. So these kind of results are not good or loving to you or anyone involved. So learning to say no is crucial, and especially really learning to say no with a heart, with a truth that you really feel why you are saying no. So that it's really, really important. And we would like to teach you today three things or four things that will help you train this and just get really, really good at it. So the first thing is to get really 100% clarity about what's actually going on. So here what is important is to really clarify two things. What is my intention? Before entering those situations, I need to be clear on what is my intention. If I want to really, really help, I need myself to be strong, I need myself to be abundant and overflowing, because from the overflow the real service happens, not from the position of weakness and, you know, having not having things and almost being able or unable to even help yourself. So you need to make, you know, you need to have this tool saying yes and no, so in order to be strong. And this is linked to my intention. If I really want to deliver my utmost service, I need to have both of those cards. And so I'm inviting you to envision a situation where saying no is the most loving, is obviously the most loving things to do. So envision this situation. In what kind of situation a no is awesome answer, really loving answer. So you create a reference point that you really, really understand with your mind and with your body why saying no in many occasions is actually the most loving things to do. So having this. And also I would like to invite you to clarify why is it that I'm saying yes, although everything feels bad about it. I'm, you know, saying yes, I feel a bit awkward, a bit tensed, and I'm over-promising and all that stuff. So why is it that I'm doing this? Am I afraid to be not being loved? Do I believe that good people always have to say yes and I want to be good people? Or I feel... I really care about how people will think about me if I say no, and that saying no is something bad. So write all that down so that you have clarity of your intention and that you have clarity over saying yes and no as a good things, as the two cards that you can use. And especially when you clarify all this, you will enable yourself to create a much better decision, a decision of higher quality next time for you and everybody involved.
Yoo-hoo. Wow, that's great. Yeah,
thanks.
And the tip number two is to, if you are a pleaser, if you are someone who keeps saying yes automatically, is to actually practice saying no. So replace your automatic default yes by a default no. And this would mean that if you don't feel that it's an awesome, big, full yes, 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 then just don't go for it. And allow yourself to say no.
Yes.
And also ask yourself, is this request actually supporting my vision? Is this supporting, you know, my mission, my message, what my gifts and what I am here to do? So if not, then it's a no. And also know that, you know, sometimes when you say no, actually you say no to an opportunity, but it's also saying yes to yourself. So when one door closes, another one opens.
Awesome. Yeah. Saying no many times is actually saying yes.
To yourself.
To yourself. Yes. So the third tip that you can use is create enough space for the right decision. So I believe here that 99% of times we don't really have to take decision at that moment of, you know, being approached or being asked. And so the strategy here is to actually prepare and train some answers that will create space. So do not jump into taking decision immediately, but actually answer in a way that you create a lot of space for yourself. Because taking the right decision, I mean, decision is the point of power. When you say yes or when you say no, you also create a stream of consequences that you will have to deal with. So, you know, if I buy the wrong house, and this means that I will have to repair it and, you know, sustain it and all this stuff for the next 2, 3, 4, 5 years or 10 years, actually now I'm dealing with the consequences of that decision. At the moment of decision, I still have the whole power. I can say yes or I can say no. And if you don't take time to really go through that and really ask your body how it feels, you know, you can end up wasting your life just dealing with the consequences of those poor decisions, and you never want to do that. So I invite you to train some of answers, find your own answers that really feel well to you, and it can look something like this. It's, you know, thank you for reaching out. I think it's a wonderful idea. I would just like to take a day or two to actually think about it, and I will let you know. Also, you can say, wow, that's an awesome idea. When do you expect my decision? And so it becomes obvious, you create space that you are not willing to do it right now and that you would like to have some time. So something in that, you know, something in the way that you will be comfortable with, but you are actually not jumping into the decision, but creating a lot of space for yourself. Mm. Yo. And the fourth and final key is...
Yeah, you mentioned it already a little bit before.
Woo-hoo.
And it's actually to listen to your body. This may sound a little bit woo-woo, but the point is here actually to feel what is a no and what is a yes within the body, you know?
Mm.
Because if you... I don't know if you are aware of it or not, but actually your body has a really great intelligence. And if you listen to your body wisdom... it really acts as a compass. Like, it can help you decide whether it's a yes or not, or no. So, for example, learn how to feel a no. So how does a no feel? It feels like you get a request from someone and then you feel like tension. You feel your body a little bit more heavy. Maybe you feel contraction, tight belly, or slight headache. So this is a no. This is the way that your body has to say no, don't go for it. And a yes would actually say, like, would feel like expansion. You feel light, you almost want to fly.
Let's go dancing. It's like,
let's
ooh.
Go dancing. You feel your open heart, you feel warmth around your heart, you maybe your palms get active. So these are the signs that your body is sending you signals to say, yes, go for it. This is how you can learn how to tune in and make better decisions.
I really hope this is helpful. Write stuff down. Try to practice, you know, practice saying no. Create space. Use the both cards, yes and no, in how you communicate.
Mm.
And don't forget that you are here to be, you know, unlocking your fullest potential, to be living your dream day after day, day after day. And we'll catch you next time in one of the next videos in Be More Academy.
The
place to be to do exactly that.
See you.